sun pouring down in the strawberry sky. Tall grass dancing down by the St. John's River side. And I can see Maggie running through the fields full of wild. A free spirit living a beloved life. Appreciating those days, growing up in Madeline, a blessed world in the southeast. I remember running barefoot well aware of sand spurs, sitting on the park bench working on guitar chords. I'm still enchanted by the legendary fantasy electric brunettes, how they would render me helpless by the way that they dressed. I've been daydreaming about the South, appreciating those days, growing up in Madeline, a blessed world in the Southeast. Recently,
Kinchant, just west of Mackay in Queensland, and I thought I'd share with you the rig that we've been using quite successfully in the short time that we've been here. Basically what we've been using is a Z-Man 6-inch swimmers. This particular lure is in the colour of a smoky shad. It's rigged on an 8-0 TT quarter ounce snakehead. This particular lure is a great attractant for these fish. Big paddle tail vibrates through the upper water column, attracting these fish. You can see behind me, very thick aquatic weed and vegetation. And we're swimming these, either trolling or casting and retrieving at shallow depths just below the surface. This knot here gets fouled by that weed, and to alleviate that problem, put a squid skirt over the top of that knot to prevent that weed from actually fouling, so it can be swum easily over that weed at shallow depth and then dropped down a little bit deeper, and then it comes back up on top of that weed again. And throughout this weed there's deeper pockets just above the weed. Lay the barramundi in ambush mode, and that's when these lures get hit. I've also been putting a bit of Procure mullet scent on the swimmers just for extra attractant for these fish, and it seems to be working extremely well. In the short time that we've been here, we've caught over 25 barramundi. The type of rod that I use is a fiberglass Silstar 6'6", 6 to 10 kilo crystal power tip. And the reason why I use a fiberglass rod is when I'm fighting these big fish, I get this rod in very acute angles, whereby if I was using a graphite or a composite rod, it would probably snap under duress stress from these fish. At times, the rod tip's underneath the kayak, and they do fight hard and pull hard. So, that's the rod. I've been using Platypus New Platinum Plus Braid in 30 pound, tied on with an improved Albright knot to Platypus 60 pound big game leader. Up the front, tying to the lead, to the lure, I have tied a loop knot. So there you go, there's the rig that I have been using. It's been very successful. I hope I've informed you enough with the way that I have been catching these fish. So consider this next time when you're at impoundments throughout Queensland that have got a lot of weed and vegetation. And I hope you have as much fun targeting these fish as what we've had on this trip. Get a look at it. Woo! Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Woo! Oh. Holy dooly. Oh. There you go. Oh. You can get that lure, it's right down its gob. Oh. This doesn't get any better. Barramundi fishing at its best. Oh. Righto. Get get the brag mat out and measure this old girl. Oh, yes. There you go. I put this squid jig over the top of the lure just because there's so much weed about. And when we're retrieving it, whether we're casting or trolling, the lure does its job. It attracts the fish. But it's that knot there that you can just see that just clips the weed and keeps on fouling. That's caught on a number 80 snakehead. Whew. Righto. Come to the shallows just to handle this fish because I really wanted to measure it. Done correctly. Always try to keep the fish upright in an upright position. This fish is every bit of 120. That's 120 centimeter barra caught from the Murray Safari H2O kayak. Oh, I'm still pumped. What I'll do later is I'll leave the kayak here and I'll paddle out just with me and the fish and release it into the deeper water. Releasing it within all this weed and vegetation is just not good for its health. It's too warm for it after being stressed and so that's the best option. I'm just going to take a few still shots and release her.
By the way.